Hello everyone, this is another session on palmistry, and in this particular palmistry video we'll be taking a look at a very strange kind of a hand. It's very different from others. Just to give a brief thing regarding what is very different in his palm is that the heart line. This is basically the heart line, and this is very very different. Like this is reaching from one end to the other portion, and it is also touching the portion of the life and the headline. This is the lifeline and this is the headline. So this line becomes extremely unique in this particular person's hand, and sometimes we also refer this particular line as the samial line. And samial line basically is when the merging of the heart and the headline means that there's no space left between the head and the heart line. It basically means that the personality becomes extremely different. It is something like they respond to situations in a very very different way. Just to give a background of this particular person, he is running a ashram, and in his ashram, he's spending a lot on the poor people, and because of the heart line being extremely long, these people become highly emotionally sensitive people and idealistic and sensitive and touchy about things. So basically they want to give lots of love, energy, money to all the people. So the person is spending huge amounts of money, and he's not caring about himself much, and this is one part. The other part is that you don't see the headline to be very distinct and clear. You would notice that the headline starts out here, it is kind of ending, and then another line basically starts. So there's a gap out here. This gap is from the age of 30. This age is approximately 33 to 35. That's when this gap is. How we calculate the age is if a person had just a normal kind of a headline, it would mean that I'm just trying to show it to you in a way where you would be able to understand how to know about the age when these events are going to take place. This is the headline and this is basically the money line. So the intersection of the head and money line is age 35. So this is when the line is breaking somewhere at the age of 33 to 35. So this point of life is when his wife left him, and he is living alone after that. Right now his age is approximately, he's aged approximately 62. So so he did gave his background as well, and he said that at this particular age he basically gave everything to his wife and basically he left. But as far as the work goes, this is basically the sun line. This is the sun line, and it is coming, it is kind of having a wave like formation. So wave like formations are not so good, but even then, because the intensity of the depth of the line is good, so as it touches the heart line, this age becomes 50 53 55, and after it crosses the heart line, this is basically the heart line, it crosses the heart line, so the age is after the age of 53 and beyond. So you would notice that the line is quite distinct and clear even after the age of 53. So basically it means that the person would have good name and fame in his field of work. Like he's running ashram, so he would have that name and fame, and at the same time he would be giving more intensity to his work. So more intensity of his work basically means that the chances basically increase that his ashram is going to grow bigger and better and better manage all these things. Although for management of the ashram to be good, the heart line should basically end somewhere out here under the Mount of Saturn, That is when basically the ashram is run in the best possible way. Somewhere at the age of 33, this is when at the age of 33, 3 years, it ran well, and somebody basically he spoiled his name. It might have been spoiled because the heartline is coming and touching the headline. This is the headline and this is the lifeline. So it's whenever the heartline is leaning backward towards the base of the palm, it is called negative. Whenever the heartline is going upward, it is basically considered to be good. So you would notice two things, that the heartline is coming here and there's a branch downward, there's a branch downward, there's another branch downward, there's another branch downward. So these are negative branches, and the whole line in itself is going up out here and reaching the headline. So all these are basically affections that are going bad. And these branches over the heartline, meaning these are creating stress and anxiety in this particular person. So these are negative signs. But the positive sign of the heartline is that whenever there's an upward swing from the heartline upward out here, and even this could be seen as an upward line, these are basically considered to be good lines. These lines can rise up from the heartline, or these lines can rise up from the headline, or these lines can rise up from the lifeline. All of these lines that are rising up towards the finger are considered to be good. These lines are basically considered to be good. These lines are considered to be good. So I'll just redraw the lines that are good. The upper line out here is good. Then the line from the headline moving towards the Mount of Jupiter means growth in one's life, because this is the area. Big planet. Big planet basically means growth in one's life, expansion in one's life. And the lines from the lifeline running upward basically means that there would be some luck during these particular years. So these are years that are for few years from this portion of life to this portion of the life. You would see 3-4 lines going upward. So all these lines are basically considered to be good, indicating that the person would be successful and he would be lucky as well. So both these things play out in his life, and now he's again thinking of closing the ashram and shifting to some other place, a better place he's thinking about. Basically, there are two ways of looking at it. The first way is that we do find excellent mount of the lines of sun indicating that the person is going to be successful after the age of 53 as well. The line is in the initial start also, but the lines are also good somewhere after the age of 53. So both periods are good, and it basically represents that whatever the person is going to do, the person is likely to be successful. So this is one way of looking at it. The other way is that as the person is growing older, like now he's reaching 62. He's 62. So at the old age, if a person ventures out to do something new, and that too in a hand where the heartline is very long and touching the headline. So what's happening is that the person in the initial period of the life, these misplaced affections or bad affections can might have a limited toll on the person, like limited effect on the person. But as a person grows older, the person also loses touch with the real life and the real situations, the dangers that might creep up suddenly in one's life. So the person needs to be more careful. It can also happen that the person might get deceived by people, so he has to be extremely careful. In that particular case, he did mention that while running his ashram, his name got spoiled because one of his juniors basically he started minting money and taking money from different people in his name. So that is basically a wrong thing. And so such people are more prone to these kind of problems when the heartland is touching the headline. So this is a negative aspect. So this is the reason why I would say that the person should not venture out to do something new. The other part is, you would notice in his hand, it's kind of many people want to know about their married life, and they normally look at the lines at the side of the palm. These are the lines people think are the marriage lines. And some people feel that if they have a long marriage line and reaching the amount of sun, it would mean that the person is going to meet a very, very famous kind of a personality, and they would have a very famous person as their partner. But this need not be true. I would say that any lines should be of normal length, not super long, and any part of your palm should not be overdeveloped or less developed. So it should be somewhere in the middle. Super strong lines or super weak lines, both lines are not considered to be good. I would explain to you in this particular case. Imagine this is one relationship and this is also a very long line. Normally people have just lines somewhere out here. So it is something like if the line is longer, the chances of it leaning downwards become more. Supposing we equate the long line to a particular weight. Let's assume a small line is 60 kilos of weight and a long line basically is 100 kilos of weight. So if you are holding a 100 kilo object in your hand, the chances of it leaning downwards become like straining, you are creating more stress in your body, are going to be more compared to a 60 kilo. So you are likely to get tired more when it's a long line, that means a 100 kilo object. So what happens is that if a person has got a super long line of attachment, what it would do is it would create more stress, anxiety, because this is the line of affection, this is the line of marriage. So long lines are not the best lines to have, or the marriage lines. In his case, we have already seen that he got married, but then he got separated as well. So both things are playing out. So it's better to have small attachments than in one's hand, not long lines. So this is again a very, very super, super long line. So it's not too good. Now we basically look at the money line. This is the money line. There's a you would notice that the intersection of the money and this particular portion is approximately age 53. And after the age of 53, you would notice that the line basically ends and a new one develops. And then this new one develops and progresses further, and then new lines are also forming. So the chances of good finances are going to be there if the lines were broken, like they were constant break, then I would have not said to be good. If the lines were very weak kind, very meek kind of lines, very, very, very weak kind of lines, those are again not considered to be good because they do not give any such result. Out here we have got multiple two lines, so two sources of income can be expected even when the person grows older. Apart from that, the person also has got two sun lines, two distinct sun lines, and that were forming a V or Y like formation towards the finger. Again, these signs are considered to be good. In one's hand, basically the way to explain these signs is that positive energies penetrate the fingers and enter the palm. When they are entering the palm, that means they are entering the life. And when they are getting trapped between two lines, like a V or a Y, it means that they remain in one's life. And the timing is when the lower portion is basically when these results start to happen. So this portion could be expected to be somewhere at the age of late 50s, 50, that's when better results can be expected. So in all, I would say a good hand. The only portion I would caution this particular person would be where the head and the heart line are joining together. This is something to be careful about. And you would notice that the heart line is much stronger compared to the head line. Its head line is also broken. So the person is going to be extremely emotionally sensitive, and the person would always be taking all decisions through. He would not be using any portion of his mind, only the heart. So people who take only heart decisions are likely to also be more emotionally sensitive and idealistic, and they are likely to get more hurt compared to people who are more realistic. So people who have the heartline ending somewhere close to the Mount of Saturn are more good at managing money well, and those people are also wise, and so those aspects. So in this case, two aspects, the upward as well as the downward. So this is the downward and this is the upward, towards the finger is always called upward, are considered, because so both things are playing out in his life. And in one, the lines are touching the heart line, the portion of the Saturn mount, and in the other it's touching the head line. This is the misplaced affection mount. If I show you his left hand, his left hand is a very, very normal kind of hand, which any normal person basically has. You would notice this is his palm, and it's the heartline is ending purely on the Saturn. So this is the best aspect to have as far as money management goes. So that's when the person basically is good at organizing his ashram well, and running his ashram well, or running his business, whatever. Basically, it's not just running the ashram, but these people run the ashram in a wise way, or they run the business in a wise way. And we would just look at the portion of the money line above the heart line. This portion, you would see that there's a break also that you see out here. Although both these lines that you see out here are strong lines, and towards the end V also portion. So I've already explained what it basically means. It is a good sign, and the break basically means probably he might venture out to do something new, even when he's old, like right now what he's planning to do. As far as his sun line goes, that is the area for how good our career is going to be. In the initial period, the line is not so good. From early period, let's say 53, and beyond 53 the line is excellent. So more name and fame is expected after the age of 53. He did mention that his ashram ran well for many years, but it was his name was spoiled also for some period. Then he made new ashram. So many events have taken place, but as far as the left hand goes, it shows that possibilities of more success coming after the age of 53. So this is a very balanced hand. The balance can be seen with the head and the heart line. They have got a gap between them. So this gap is the portion where the emotions and the thought process mingle together. The thought process comes from the head line, and the emotions come from the heart line. So they mingle together in the portion in the middle, and the decisions are made. If there's a gap between both these lines, the chances of a balanced decisions are there. If there's no gap, then the person is tilted only towards one side. So I would say a good hand, and good things should be expected. And before I basically end my video, I would just show something that I normally go to everybody. Press the subscribe button, press the bell icon to get regular updates from me. Palmistry video consists of various permutation combinations. We as palmists may miss out on many points. This is just a partial palmistry reading of the palm. The best reading comes out with a dialogue and not a monologue. Generally, every client wants to ask about name, fame, money, health, family life. Not everything can be known by the lines. Less lines without any special signs can give excellent result. You need not have a fish, lotus, M sign I don't believe in, Trishul is good, pointing towards a finger, it's good. But even if you don't have it, it's perfectly fine. It's not that if you have Trishul, only then you are going to be successful. Simple lines, just a simple line can do, can give you the best result. And even if someone does not have a money or a sun line or a career line, it does not mean no money and no career. In fact, it may be the best sign, and it might mean unlimited possibilities. Palmistry is not just about lines. It's more about hand structure, feel, size, padding over the mounts, and they play a greater role. Every hand is different and every hand basically tells a story. You would notice every hand is different. Some hands are very thin, some hands are very well padded. Well padded hands are considered to be better, more rich. Like in this case, you see the hands to be well padded. So I would just end the video now and request you to press the subscribe button and then press the bell icon to get regular updates from me. Bye and take care. Thanks for watching. And do give your comments down below.